The math of this meme is wrong. And not just by a little bit, it's way off. The numbers are not even close. And it's not just this meme that has that problem. A lot of posts on social media mess up the math, either on accident because they don't know any better, or on purpose to make a point. Either way, consumers of media should be prepared to engage such posts as skeptics and practice good quantitative literacy. Quantitative literacy, or sometimes called numeracy, is the math and statistics skills needed to successfully navigate everyday life. Reposting a problematic meme like this, even if you agree with the sentiment, is just bad and contributes to the social media misinformation epidemic. So let's go through and find out all the ways this meme is wrong. As many of you know, our channel is sponsored by Brigham Young University's Department of Mathematics Education and College of Computational, Mathematical, and Physical Sciences. We're now looking for other sponsors and donors to help support the students that work on this important project. Our mission is to share with the world how mathematics, statistics, and probability are used and can be used to understand the world around us. We especially hope that our content gets used by teachers and is seen by students. Although there are a lot of math and stats channels out there, very few focus on this particular area, and it's an area where students and parents say that school math is lacking the most. If you have extra money you would like to put to a good cause, you can donate to our channel through this website. Instructions on how to donate on the website are in the description. And if you're associated with a company or an institution that would like to partner with Math the World as a sponsor, please reach out to us by emailing mattheworld@byu.edu. Thank you so much. A foundational skill in quantitative literacy is to release your inner skeptic. So many individuals, groups, institutions, governments, and businesses are trying to pull the wool over your eyes to make you believe something that isn't true or only partially true. So let's release our inner skeptic on this post. The first red flag is that there's no citation given to know what data they used or even what year the data refers to. That should raise your suspicions right away since readers can't check up on the values or the process used to get the numbers. The second red flag is that they don't clarify which average they are using. Is this the mean or the median or something else? An average can refer to various measures of central tendency. The third red flag was that it doesn't pass the sniff test. According to the meme, the top 10 highest income individuals earn 12.67% of all US income. That is a crazy amount of money. I looked up the total US income in 2022 and I calculated 12.67% of that amount. It was over $1.7 trillion. That's an average of $170 billion for each of the top 10 earners in 1 year. And a quick internet search showed that no one in the US has ever got close to that with their increase in wealth, let alone in yearly income. So there's no way that 10 people have averaged that in income. The fourth red flag is that there is no specifications as to the unit of analysis. Are these values averaged across all US individuals or across US households or something else? There's a big difference between individuals and households. For example, if we're averaging over all individuals in the US, that includes about 40% of the population 16 and older that are not employed and will significantly lower the average income value. It would lower the average income even more if it was distributed across all individuals, including those younger than 16. I did some research to see if I could find the average value used in the meme, and I found that in the 2022 census, the median household income was $74,580. The years around that were not as close to the value in the meme of $74,500, so it looks like that has answered some of our questions. It's a median, not a mean, and it's household, not individual. Well, this leads to the first egregious error of the meme. If they are using household median income as the measure, then there is no way they used the median for these other values below, because medians are robust against outliers, and that is what the top earning households are. Dropping 10 individuals at the top would hardly change the median income at all, maybe a penny, but I doubt even that. Dropping the top 50, maybe a few cents, the top 100, probably not even a dollar. I don't have access to the census data, so I can't find that exact median value, but we could estimate it. I was able to find the distribution of US household income for 2023, which is 1 year later, and it shows that it takes about 3.5% of the households around the median to change a value of $5,000. Well, there were about 131.4 million households in the 2022 US Census, and 3.5% of 131.4 million is about 0.4599, or 0.46 million, or 460,000 households, approximately. That means there's an approximate mean change in household income around the median of 0.010869, etc. That's barely more than a penny. So dropping the top 10 individuals would lower the median income by about a dime, which was more than my guess of a penny. Dropping the top 50, you drop about 55 cents, and dropping the top 1,000, about $11. So we could update the numbers to be the following: 74,500, 74,500, 74,499, 74,489. There's not much change between these numbers. These numbers are so far off of the values in the meme, I'm thinking the meme had to be a joke. Seriously, how do they go from dropping the income by a dime to almost 10 grand? This is so egregious. So now, I'm on a new quest. I had to try to find out how the creators of the meme actually got their numbers. My first thought was that they had to be doing calculations assuming the average was a mean rather than the median. That's the only way I could see them getting large drops in the median. Somehow they must have estimated the total income of the US, subtracted the income of the top 10 or 50 or 1,000, and then redistributed the rest across the rest of the US population. It took a lot of experimentation, but I finally found out how they did get their numbers, with two more blatantly egregious errors. So, what did they do? First, they estimated the total US income by multiplying the median US income by the number of US households. Well, this is a huge error. Medians are not connected to the total amount like means are. If we had the mean US household income, then we could find the total US income. The mean income value is the value each would get if we evenly distributed the total across all households. So we can recover the total by multiplying the mean by the number of households. But you can't do the same with the median unless the distribution is symmetric and income is largely skewed, so it's not symmetric. Their calculation, median times households, gets a total US income of this, or under $10 trillion. But the actual total income for 2022 was this, about $14 trillion. I found that estimate by multiplying the mean 2022 US income of $106,400 times the 131.4 million households. So right away, the meme creators lost more than $4 trillion of income in their calculations, almost 30% of the total US income. That's going to make things look much worse than they actually are. The second egregious error I found is the value the creators used for the income of the top individuals. I spent a lot of time trying to track down the income of the richest Americans in 2022. I eventually was able to find published estimates of the income of the top 5 richest people. This process alone raised a red flag. Where did the meme creators get their values for the income of the top 1,000 and 50 and 10 Americans? Reported income to the US government is not publicly available, and it took some research by journalists to find values to report for the income of the richest 5 individuals. So my guess is that the meme creators are not actually using income. It turns out that the income of the top 5 richest Americans, about $32.4 billion, was really driven by Elon Musk. His income was reported by CNN to be about $29.3 billion, $11 billion of which went to taxes. Most of this was generated through exercising stock options that were worth $23.6 billion. The income of the other 4 were quite modest, especially Warren Buffett, around $400,000, and Jeff Bezos, around $1.7 million. So there are certainly people that had higher incomes that year than Warren Buffett and Jeff Bezos, so maybe I shouldn't include them in the top 10. But by the life of me, I don't know how to find the top 10 Americans with the highest income that year. But stay with me, because we will find that the meme creators did actually use values from all 5 of these richest men in their calculations. So let's try out their math. We incorrectly multiply the median income by the number of households to get a total, then subtract out the total income of the top 10, and since I could only find the income of the top 5 richest Americans, I'll double the values as an estimate of the income of the top 10. And after the subtraction, we divide the total by the number of households, minus 10, and we get a meaningless average of $74,000-ish. Well, that did drop the average by about $500. So how in the world did they get a drop of almost 20 times that? I'm not even close to getting the value they did. So the creators must have subtracted a value off that was much larger than the estimate of my top 10 income. I had a breakthrough when I thought that the creators must not have subtracted off income, but wealth. There's a big difference between income and wealth. Income is the amount of salary or pay realized in a year, and is the amount you put on a tax form, versus wealth, which is the total value of all the assets you own minus debt. If your stock portfolio increases in value, or you have real estate or other assets that increase, it's not considered income. For a large percentage of U.S. households, their wealth increases each year more than their income. This is certainly true of the top 10 richest Americans. I found estimates of the wealth of the top 10 in 2021 and 2022 from datasets on Kaggle.com, and I calculated how much their wealth increased. As a group, their total wealth increased an estimated $194.2 billion. Replacing income of the top 10 with the increase in wealth of the top 10 in the previous calculation gets us a value of $73,000, or just a touch more. Well, that's a little lower, but still not even close to the reported $65,000. We have to subtract a much larger amount. The largest amount I could conceive of is the total lifetime accumulated wealth of the top 10 instead of their change of wealth. Let me emphasize that this is a totally different value than 1 year's worth of income, or even 1 year's growth in wealth. This is really subtracting apples from oranges. Well, it isn't even that close. The total lifetime accumulated wealth of the top 10 in 2022 was $1,264.7 billion. That is about 20 times the estimate of the income of the top 10. If we throw that value into the calculation as the quote-unquote income of the top 10, then we start to see the light. We get darn close to that $65,000 on the meme. So to make the situation look as bad as possible, the creators of the meme reduced the total income of the US by $4 trillion and subtracted off a value about 20 times the income of the top 10. No wonder it looks so bad. So many bad things are happening here. Well, what should the values be? Well, we already saw what the values should have been, looking at the median values each time. But if we want to use the mean instead of the median, so subtracting off the high incomes make a bigger effect, then the top two values would be these. A drop of about $500, which is still a big drop, but a far cry from 10 grand. I didn't take time to try to estimate income of the top 50 or 1,000. But what if the creators really wanted to subtract off the total accumulated wealth of the richest Americans? Then we should compare that to the total accumulated wealth of all Americans, so we're comparing apples to apples. The total US wealth in 2022 was estimated to be just under $200 trillion. That's all real estate, vehicles, stocks, pensions, business equity, etc., minus existing debt. Evenly distributed across all households, that's an average accumulated wealth of about $1.5 million. That's quite a lot. Subtracting off the wealth of the top 10 and evenly distributing again drops the mean US wealth by the same value as the original mean, about 9.5 grand. But the percentage drop is quite different now. It's only about 2/3 of 1% rather than 12.75%. Don't get me wrong, the top 10 richest people in the US do make a lot of money and have a crazy amount of wealth, but it isn't nearly as bad as this meme and many others make it out to be. Okay, so what's the point? You need to be very cautious about what you come across online. There is so much misinformation out there that it can lead you to believe things that simply aren't true, and aren't even close to true. If something looks suspect, do some research. I heard from different sources that billionaires in the US have a small effective tax rate. That didn't match up to the values reported by CNN about how much Elon Musk paid in taxes in his 2022 taxes, which was a rate of about 37.5%. Well, after doing research, I found that those doing the calculations to estimate the billionaire tax rate did a similar mistake that our meme creators made. They didn't use realized income, they used an estimate of their wealth increase as their income to make it look like they did not pay much tax. It doesn't seem comparable to consider the change in wealth as income for some when calculating the tax rate, but not in others. Tens of millions of households' wealth increases through real estate appreciation or stock market investments or business growth, but it isn't counted on their tax rate calculation, so why do this for billionaires? Again, I'm not doing this to argue that there's not a dramatic inequity in our country, just that there is massive misinformation out there about so many aspects of our society that we must be careful how we digest what we are exposed to. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share our videos. Be sure to follow Math the World on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your support.